Are they aging? Can we get rid of them? Hi, I'm Dr. Johnny. We're talking about smoker's lines or vertical lip lines. How do you prevent them and how do you get rid of them? So smoker's lines or vertical lip lines, there's so many people don't smoke and get them. They're very aging and they're key to prevent. So today I'm gonna go through a few things you can do at home and in the physician's office to help prevent and get rid of them. You don't see them in the very young, but they start typically at the age of 25 to 35 in many people, especially lighter skin. Loss of collagen, hyperdynamics, and we're learning a lot more about the movement of the face and how that affects aging. We also know that there's bone loss and fat loss around the mouth. Let's talk about the first two stages. There's really two stages in my mind. Number one is I call the flashing stage. It's like the light, like a flashing light. And you only see when people are chewing, talking, or whistling. That's when a good friend should tell a person that it's happening. Because people don't know. They don't go home and look in the mirror and talk, or eat, or chew. And a lot of times they don't know until they're actually seeing the line in the skin. But the early stage is where we want to get them. That's stage one. Stage two, the line is ingrained and etched into the skin. These are very difficult to get rid of. We can reduce them, it's expensive, and it's always at the risk of making an unnatural look if we're not patient with it. So stage one is where you can do the most at home. Number one, a retinol or Retin-A preferably to improve collagen and dermal thickness. Number two, a vitamin C works very well for this along with a Retin-A. And number three, of course, prevention with SPF. A couple things for habits. Number one, don't drink through a straw. No whistling. And people don't like the third one, and that is not chewing gum. A lot of people who are gum chewers, they can't stop chewing. And that chewing is creating a hyperdynamic environment in the lower face. In females, a lot of times, you just see a continual pursing of the lips as a natural expression. And a lot of times people have to tell you that's what you're doing because a lot of people don't realize it. But it's from a lack of support of the tissues and loss of collagen, and people sit there in a pursed position and it just forms those lines. Now we're in the office. What can you do in the office? There's less invasive things that you can do, such as radiofrequency or ultrasound skin tightening, microneedling, the lasers, we're talking non-injectables here, or even fractionated radiofrequency, which is what I use a lot. Next, we go in finally to injectables. And these really have the most punch, but they also, you have to be ready for some of the consequences and also working with your provider because it's an area that's dynamic. Everyone looks at it when they're talking to you, they notice the mouth. You can't overfill. The first thing, neuromodulators or Botox-like products. Works amazing. Do this early, even at stage one, this works. Just about 6 units. 90% of people will tolerate it. The first time they get it, they might talk differently, be unable to whistle, but that's because it was hyperdynamic for a while. That goes away. It's one of the most cost-effective ways. Almost all my patients do neuromodulator around the lip. The next one for injectables, of course, is fillers. And I don't recommend a lot of people do permanent fillers. Here in this clip, you see me use a microcannula with PMMA or bellafill, and I'm just using it to create a bit of volume where there's loss. You never want to overfill. If you're going to overfill, you want to do a hyaluronic acid product that you can then remove if you don't like it, because you have to create that perfect ski jump. So be very careful with permanent products here, but it can be done. This is the most common. People use hyaluronic acid either in a linear threading technique or a little droplet along each line. And oftentimes, this is where you use a less robust hyaluronic acid, especially the first time, so that you don't see where you actually put the filler. So those are vertical lip lines. A lot of people ask for an update on that. You basically throw the kitchen sink at it. You prevent it as much as you can, and everything else very judiciously. Nothing to be overdone. Vertical lip lines, prevent them at stage one. What do you do? What's been successful for you? Let us know in the comments below. Also follow over on Instagram. We have great discussions over there to keep your skin and body beautiful, healthy, and vibrant.